16 teams all in a battle for one goal, to lift Lord Stanley and fulfill a childhood dream, having their name on the cup. 2 months, blood, sweat, and broken bones. Buckle up, fans. It's the NHL playoffs. Last Man In, episode number 38, and our playoff preview show.
What's half of 38?
I don't know.
19.
God damn it.
Why?
It takes 16 wins to win the Stanley Cup. I thought I'd...
Did you not pass high school math?
Or were you math is my strong suit.
I think he talked really? Before he thought it through.
Yeah, I was kind of excited.
As most people, like...
Most sports fans
No, do. Sorry. I'm sorry. He probably didn't do much thinking today at all, because he's wearing a Minnesota Wild shirt and a Calgary Flames hat. You know there's no way both those teams could win the cup, right?
It's not just any Minnesota Wild shirt. It's a Oh That Flow Mikael Granlund player tee.
Is there anyone that you don't admire their flow? Like,
no, I don't like a lot of flow, but Mikael Granlund gets the pass.
Why does he get the pass?
Because he's awesome.
Because he scores, what, 7 goals?
Because he's beautiful, Greg.
Adam Lowry had more points than he did this year, I believe.
Okay. Hey, Greg, oh, that's a fun fact. Did you guys see how many points Johnny Gaudreau had this year? And how many points a top scorer in the Jets had this year? A rookie outscored the Jets team.
That's fine. The same. They didn't need it. Buckle up. Who finished with more points?
On the season?
Yeah.
I think Calgary did.
Nope. Jets finished 99. Okay, fine. Calgary finished 97.
Calgary, thank you. You should be saying thank you.
You should be saying thank you to that AHL squad they have, because they somehow made the playoffs.
No, they got you into the playoffs, so you're welcome. First off, thank you.
Well,
thank
here's you. The other thing, and to it's trump true. Your argument.
It's true.
Thanks Alberta, little... though, because Edmonton won as well.
Exactly. But to trump your argument, Jamie Benn won Art Ross, and he did not make the playoffs. So scoring does not correlate playoff. Burst.
Yeah, I'm not denying that. Okay. Jamie Benn, first star of the week. Because I saw Jets fans were like, how come Andre Pavlik didn't get first star? And I'm like, because Jamie Benn had two nights back-to-back 4 points. And did you see like that
and
last...
And he had 2 points in the last 2 minutes of the game.
I know, did you see that timeout where they were like, okay, you're not coming off the ice. And he shakes it and he's like, no. And then they're like, no, yeah. And then he's like, he was so close. Like,
let's put it this way. They have to be happy about something in Dallas this year, because that team was not very good.
They had, you know what, they was all...
I think they had 90 points.
Anyone in the Central would be very they proud had because one more you point. Killed it. You killed they it, had, you just didn't kill it enough.
Dallas had one more point than they had last year. Last year they made the playoffs.
Yeah, but this year we this talked year about they weren't all even the close. Guys are crazy who made the playoffs.
Here's the other thing, and obviously we'll get into our first playoff preview right away, but it's interesting how this is only the second year of the wildcard era. And the Central Division is the only division to, both years, have 5 teams in the playoffs.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because Dallas crossed over to play.
Oh, yeah, well, it just cements that it is the toughest division in hockey, because there's not really a bad, there's not really a bad team.
No, there isn't, and that
every
was
team was above 500.
That's well proven over. In the standings.
Didn't they all have 90 points or more?
It took until the like a week and a half left in the season for all the Central teams to get eliminated from the playoffs.
Correct me if I'm wrong, though. Colorado had 90 points. They were the last team, last
That's
place.
That's a lot of points.
That's ridiculous.
Maybe they had 88, but yeah, they still had a ridiculous amount of points.
So it makes the Jets playoff, making the playoffs a little bit more impressive, actually.
Well, they had to play those teams. They had to beat them.
They're almost, just the high, okay, let's high get into it. All right.
So, we'll
Wait,
go with
what
the...
Wait, did we cut you off on?
We'll,
I don't know. What?
We'll oh, go okay, with sorry. The Western bias. Because we're tired of everyone focusing on the East first.
You don't want to save Jets for last?
What?
No, we're
is
starting...
Is there an East bias?
There's an Eastern bias. Why are we saying... The thing is we're going to talk about the Jets for like 30 minutes. Talk
That's
about
true.
Every other team
Let's
for about
go.
Five.
All right. Yeah, you're right.
So we're going to hammer out every other one first?
No,
we're going to hammer out Jets first.
We'll hammer okay. out Jets slowly okay. and painfully.
And here's the thing. Like, these are things that should be discussed before the podcast, not while we're recording.
Yeah. We're professionals.
We're this really, is why, really organized, guys.
This is why we got all the views and yeah. all that ad revenue money from YouTube.
This is why we'll be on TV in like 25 years.
If Jeff O'Neill's on TV, there's hope for everyone.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Calm Jeff O'Neill.
Jeff
we'll,
O'Neill.
We'll get to that, because that surprised me quite a bit.
Okay.
Considering he hated the Jets 6 months ago, and he's coming here for the first playoff game now. So
is he?
Whatever. Hmm. Yep.
So Winnipeg got the pleasure of having their first playoff berth in since coming back to Winnipeg, so 4 years. And first playoff berth as a whole franchise since 2007. Still looking for their first playoff win as a franchise.
Did they score in that series?
Yeah.
How many?
3.
No.
I don't know.
Quite a bit.
Oh, okay.
That's I don't fine. Know.
But, and they get to draw one of the Stanley Cup favorites in Anaheim Ducks. A series that I think a lot of people would have loved to have had last year.
Timu. Oh, he's trying to make the connection. Yeah. He's okay.
You'll bet he'll be watching this one.
He's good.
Yes. So, a little rundown of what has happened so far this season between Winnipeg and Anaheim. Season series went 3-0 to Anaheim. However, in that series, there was two of the three games were in extra time. And these two teams have not played since middle of January.
Which means...
the Ducks have yet to see Myers, Stafford, Stepniak, Tolusti. They have not seen a caneless...
and a healthy decor. Because yes, that was when we had five defensemen gone.
And they also have not seen a caneless Jets yet, which is going to be a little bit different. They have not seen the Jets play the way they have. And I think that that's... something that's definitely one of the biggest storylines of this is the fact that they haven't played in so long. This series seems to be getting a lot of attention from outside media as well, not just media inside Winnipeg. It seems to be getting a lot of attention from everyone else just because it's Winnipeg's first time. And a lot of people feel that Winnipeg has a legitimate shot to win this series. What do you guys think so far?
Well, in TSN's preview show, that's our equivalent to ESPN, I guess.
They also... do a lot of stuff with NBCSN.
TSN's probably still the biggest hockey.
Of course.
That
here
preview. I think that preview show was more watched than some of the broadcasts that Sportsnet's had this year.
Well, of course, that's because you're getting all the fans.
I think Americans revert to TSN for hockey coverage because ESPN doesn't do. They do 30 seconds of an hour broadcast.
I don't know. If you're in the States, let us know. What kind of hockey coverage you guys have? I know they have NBCSN, which is a big.
Melbury,
Roenick.
Well, now they have Cuthbert that's covering one game of all the Canadian cities. So because like everyone on
English.
What?
Everyone on NBC has shared contracts worked in with their TSN contract to do play by play announcing with NBC. Even McKenzie will get loaned to them. So there's always going to be guys there. So TSN and NBC kind of have this working relationship. So I think a lot of people go to NBC for their hockey stuff. But
well, yeah, in their playoff preview, this was a series like Ducks versus Jets. It was their pick 'em. It was like they couldn't pick a clear-cut winner.
I think you can go down this list and you can make arguments for both teams on both sides. However, yes, this is honestly on paper. No one knows what Winnipeg's going to bring because no one's seen Winnipeg in the playoffs. And we don't know what we're going to get out of Pavlik. Or we don't know if Hutchinson's going to come in and merge. The great thing is about Anaheim is they don't have an established... you could argue that Frederick Anderson is an established goaltender. His numbers aren't that impressive.
He's the goalie who's played the most games out of all the goalies in the series. 52 this season.
If you ask me...
he also faced less shots than Pavlik. Or no, faced around the same number of shots. However, the overall save percentage between the goalies... I think we had an average of 917. Ducks were around 915. It's not telling, but it does show that Jets don't allow a lot of shots and Jets shoot a lot. So it'll be interesting to see.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know.
You're waiting. You're like drawing for a chance to talk, and then you say, "I don't know."
Well,
yeah,
I had a comment thrown, and I forgot what I was gonna say.
Oh, that's the worst.
I don't know, but my opinion, I think the Jets have a decent shot to win. I mean, and I've been blown away by how many hockey experts have actually picked the Jets not only to beat Anaheim, but to go decently far in the playoffs.
Well,
I mean, I've seen Sportsnet pick the Jets to go conference finals. I've seen Bob McKenzie said Jets out of all the Canadian teams, he thinks Jets will go the farthest. I've seen Jeff O'Neill go as far as to say the Jets are their cup pick. So, I mean, and Sportsnet, too. I don't know if I said that, but they picked them to... I don't know. I'm kind of blown away by how much support, I guess, they're getting. I think they have a legitimate shot to win. I think they're outmatched on offense by Anaheim, but I think defensively and in net, I think the Jets have the advantage. I mean, goaltending could be a toss-up. You never know with Pavlik, but I think defensively, and I think the Jets, they're going to be hard to play, because lots of comparisons I've heard have been to the LA Kings from 3 years ago, who barely made the playoffs and then completely
dominated.
And I've heard that, and that I don't know if the Jets are at that stage considering how many young guys they have on their team, but I certainly think they can beat Anaheim. I do.
And here's my kind of comment or my thing on that is Last year, Anaheim almost lost to Dallas, and Dallas was a much more inferior team to what Winnipeg is this year, I think. Even though I think Dallas has that top-end scoring talent, I think as a whole, I don't see Dallas being as strong. The great thing about this series is whether it's Frederik Andersen, who last year got pulled in his series against Dallas, and then was turned over to John Gibson, who then went back to Frederik Andersen, I think. Or maybe Jonas Hiller got time as well. But Anaheim had no clue who their goalie was last year in the playoffs, and that might be the same case again this year. The thing that I think that helps the Jets out is if you look at their defensive core, I think it's a strong, older, more veteran defensive core. Sure, there's not a ton of playoff experience. You know, you have Byfuglien, Stewart, and Myers who have experienced playoff action before. However, you have Enstrom who's been never in the playoffs.
Whoa.
Yeah, Slater. Okay. Is it Slater or Thorburn's the only one left from the 07 team?
Slater. But I mean, you.
But no,
guys like Party and Harrison have been in the playoffs. They're not, you know, they kind of know what it's about.
True, but if the team's fully healthy, they're not drawing in. Sherratt, no. It's going to be Sherratt, Byfuglien, Enstrom, yeah. Myers, Stewart.
But they're still going to be in the room. They're still going to be around the guys. So
exactly.
I mean,
but what my point is saying is, if you look, they're an older core. They're not. They're 27 average age, I believe, or something around that number. Compared to what you have in Anaheim, where you have the young guys like Cam Fowler, Sammy Vatanen, Hampus Lindholm, and that's a much younger core, a core that's probably more susceptible to make defensive lapses. Now, I think the other reason why a lot of I'm not going to say professionals, but experts, we'll call them, are picking Winnipeg over Anaheim, or why they feel Winnipeg is a legitimate shot to beat Anaheim, is because Anaheim has pretty much had the Pacific locked up all season. Their last meaningful game might have been in February. They have not played playoff hockey in probably 2 months. They never had to go through the craziness of stepping their game up. You saw what happened in Nashville and Chicago. Nashville and Chicago let their foot off the gas and they stumbled over the finish line. And then you see these other teams, like the Vancouvers, the Calgarys, the Winnipeg, St. Louis, and Minnesota, who all had to keep gung-ho to not only make the playoffs, but further get somewhere in the West. It was, I just haven't seen that out of Anaheim, and I think a lot of people think that Anaheim's going to definitely stumble out of the gate. And if the Jets can win one in Anaheim, it's going to be tough for Anaheim to win a game here, just because that place is going to be loud.
If the Jets
stay... A storm is coming.
If the Jets stay... yeah.
Cam's going to be the one guy there, sorry to interrupt. Cam's going to be the one guy in the arena wearing blue, just saying...
I won't be there.
Anarchy. Anarchy.
Yeah.
If the Jets stay out of the penalty box, I think they'll win. Because I don't think Anaheim can match them physically. They'll give them a good run for their money physically, more so than the other teams could. But I think the Jets have too much momentum. I think they play too physical. I think they're too big. And I think Dustin Byfuglien is going to piss off Corey Perry and Ryan Getzlaff.
So much.
Pretty quick.
Yeah. And it's one of those things where...
So, I don't know. I mean...
We're a feisty unit, and I want to say Winnipeg's going to win the series, but it's so tough for me to fully commit just because of lack of experience as a team in the playoffs. There are so many individuals in that room who've experienced playoff hockey, and I hope they can bring that. And all we've heard since they've made it is how much they've deserved it, how good, how close-knit the guys are in the room, how everyone seems to be a big group of friends. And that, to me, is another reason why they could win the series. Yeah. But you got to remember that this is only the first year that they're in the playoffs. Probably many more to come. So don't get all hopped up if they lose in the first round. Because you know what? It's a building block.
Yeah.
If you look at a team, sorry to interrupt again, if you look like a team like Tampa Bay, who's now one of the Cup favorites, and we'll get to them later, they started last year with the first round exit. It happens. Montreal's had it. Washington's had it. Islanders had it. Rangers have had it. This is a stepping stone to get players to come here, and I think we're going to get a better team out of it. Why are you smiling?
I think you just say at all these teams, and I thought, there's only two times Calgary has left the first round, and they went to the Cup final both times, only won once.
I didn't say Calgary, though.
No, I know, but
I know I didn't Calgary, mention Calgary
multiple times. Yeah, yeah. Well, no. Yeah, there you go. They're unproven after that.
Pass. I think
you got to get
the Jets, though. Like, they said it the other night, they've got 300 and some odd games as a team in terms of playoffs with guys they have on their team.
That's fair.
I mean, and if you look at it, their leaders are guys that have been there before.
Yep.
Wheeler, that's Stewart, right. Bufflin, Ladd.
Wheeler's been there?
Boston. Yeah, with Boston for like 2 years, maybe.
Yeah.
Oh.
So because remember, Boston wasn't always a team that missed the playoffs. Like,
yeah.
Remember that.
He was there the year that... he was there the year they were up 3-0 and they blew it.
Yes, Philly. He was.
What was I going to say? I don't know. I mean, I think they've got a shot. I do.
Okay, so anything else to say on the series before we make our predictions?
Actually, let's just make our predictions. We'll start with Dan, the Jets.
Dan.
The homer.
The aficionado.
Atlanta Thrashers fan.
I'm kind of stuck on the games, but I'm going to say Jets in 7.
Okay.
You're
Ducks in 6. Someone's got to be the antagonist, and I'm ready for that role.
No, that's fine.
Here's the reason.
Can I have a devil's advocate call here?
It's fair to pick Anaheim.
No,
it's fair.
I was just going to say, okay, I agree with both sides, but everyone seems to be forgetting, at least in Winnipeg media, because I've heard it a lot, the Ducks also have guys, Corey Perry, Ryan Getzlaf, that's fine. They also have Ryan Kessler. Mm-hmm. Like
He can't play in the series, actually.
Why is that?
Olympic trials for the diving team are on, that's why.
Oh.
We could be a part of the jokes, guys.
Okay.
Yeah, but I...
No, Ducks at 6, yeah. Jets at 7. The one thing I think we can all agree on, I want this to be a long series. I don't care if they're Jets sweep, that by all means, but it'd be beautiful.
I think it'll be a grind. I think it'll be...
Go ahead, Greg. Let me have it.
Okay. I think... I'm picking the Jets to win this series. I'm going to pick them in 6 games. Reason being, if they have a chance to clinch at home, they're not missing that chance to clinch at home.
And that is why I was caught on games.
And here's the other thing. I don't see them not taking a game in Anaheim just because they have all that momentum, and I feel like game one is a win. I'm not going to drink it.
I will say it. I think they're going to win the first game.
I have them taking game 2 and 3. In my head, 2 and 3.
Okay.
They're not losing game 3. I don't think so.
Here's the other thing that I'm going to put out there. Is if the Ducks win this series, it's got to be in 5 games because you cannot let Game 6 happen, because if Game 6 happens...
No.
Game 7 happens.
Game 7 happens because they're not losing in 6. I understand your point to that. If this series comes back for a third game...
I can't take Game 7 stress, so that's why I chose 6.
I've had the most stressful Game 7 ever!
You guys witnessed
it!
You know what, though?
I can't do it either, but I'm going to!
I've seen this. I've read this in a couple of playoff previews, and I'm going to throw it out there. If the Jets get past Anaheim...
They're making it to the conference final!
They're making it to the conference final, because I don't think Vancouver or Calgary are nearly as good as the team that was Winnipeg.
Sir, we'll get to that in a moment.
I don't think either of those teams can handle how the Jets play in 7-game series.
Coming off of the momentum of winning their first series.
I don't think. I don't think Calgary has the talent, period. And I don't think Vancouver can handle the physical play.
To Dan's point, though, everyone has been saying all year how Calgary doesn't have... And I agree 100%. I don't think Calgary's got the talent, but there's some voodoo...
There's something going on
and
there.
And bullshit.
Their hashtag is beautiful.
You know
hashtag
why?
Never quit.
I figured it out.
Never quit.
Bob Hartley coaches the Calgary Flames. Bob Hartley coached the Atlanta Thrashers when they made the playoffs.
Bob Hartley coached Colorado when they won a cup.
I'm just saying something.
Do you know if you put a capital A, what's inside a capital A? A triangle. Illuminati. Boom.
Oh, shit.
Nailed it.
Shit.
Okay.
No. To move on, obviously, so we've all... made our picks.
So you
Jets, and you... Dan and I picked Jets. You have Ducks.
Ducks.
Okay.
Yep.
Let's move to the next series.
I'm just saying, someone's got to be the antagonist, and I'm prepared to play that role.
Let's play Vancouver-Calgary. Now, here's the thing. The winner of the series will have to go up against the winner of Winnipeg-Anaheim. A lot of people feel that the winner of the series, whether it's Vancouver or Calgary,
will be a doormat for the Western Conference Final.
Will be a doormat to the Pacific Division champion, which, yes, could be the Winnipeg Jets, even though they're not in that division.
They win the series,
they're technically the Pacific Division champion.
Oh, so they get a banner?
Yeah, that says Pacific Division
No.
They're just known
as for the playoffs.
Yeah.
Ah, oh, damn.
They won't get a banner.
However, if they win the Western Conference, then they get a banner.
But
that's besides the point.
Yeah.
Vancouver-Calgary. Calgary won this series, season series 2-1-1. So what do you guys think of this all-Canadian matchup that obviously CBC and Sportsnet have a gigantic boner on?
Flashbacks to 04 when Calgary-Vancouver played in the first round and Calgary upset them, because that was fun to watch.
Is Miller back? That's my question.
Is Miller back? How do you not play Eddie Lack with how well he's played in the last two months?
You can't not.
Yeah, well, this is what
Eddie Lack's going to Buffalo, guys, so we should focus on that.
This is what you do. To add to Dan's point, you play Lack until he falters, because your number one goalie is right there.
If he falters, then...
Agreed.
I don't understand Calgary. I don't get them. I mean...
I don't think anyone gets them.
Their top line...
Their Corsi is terrible.
Their top line, three very good players. I know two of them are young, but they look like they're going to be star players.
Who, Yuri Hudler? Yuri Hudler.
Yeah, Hudler, obviously, of course.
Hudler and Josh Harris?
I don't get them, though. Here's my dilemma. Their defensive core, their defense is strong. Their goaltending is, it's pretty good. But their top defenseman has been out for 2 months.
But they've been probably a better team without him.
I know. I don't get it. And, like...
No one.
They take the second least amount of penalties.
Here's what I don't get. I watched the Jets-Flames game on Saturday, which meant absolutely nothing.
It was a professional shinny game. That was one of the most enjoyable games
ever. The Jets sat out 8 regulars. Calgary sat out 8 regulars. The Jets still look like an NHL team. Calgary looked like a glorified AHL team.
Because they were playing like a ton of rookies and they weren't
Andrew Kopp got his first NHL point in that
There's no depth on Calgary. I don't get it. There's no depth.
You don't need to get it. They made it. They did it.
I know. It baffles me.
It's weird because it's very hard to determine who's going to win. Like, it's one of those things where Calgary's been doing crazy. Like, they made a deal with the devil is what they've done. Like, this is the only thing that explains this season. Bob Hartley went to some place over the summer and sold his soul for this.
Did he coach them last year too?
Yeah. He had that art. Dude, if Tortorella was still there, it would be the reignitement of the time where Tortorella almost fought Bob Hartley. But no, Tortorella.
He's got magic then. Because, I mean, his second year in Atlanta, 90 points. Third year in Atlanta, 97 points, division title, playoffs. And that was a team that no one thought was ever going to be any good. So
a team that also had...
I mean, they had more than Calgary did, but I'm
no.
You know, he's a...
But Johnny Goudreau, guys.
Okay, yeah. Well, here's...
The Calder runner-up.
To who? Ekblad?
The Stone Man.
You have to.
We'll get to that, Stoner. But you have to.
Here's what we all watch a preview show, so I'm just going off preview show and things I've heard and read. Calgary, let's just say Calgary and the Sedins, Goudreau line, Sedin line, they null each other out. Mm-hmm. Vancouver still has secondary scoring. Calgary's secondary scores were their decor. Yes, I get that. You already know who I'm picking, but I'll just say
picking the team he didn't watch all year, but claims he's
I'm at a loss for words as to... I'm very excited for this series, but I also, in the back of my mind, am with everyone else, which I shouldn't be, which the winner of this series most likely will be a stepping stone for the whoever Ducks and Jets win.
Now, here's the other thing.
And I wish it wasn't.
Don't get me wrong. I'm happy to see Calgary there. I think the more Canadian teams in, the better. I just don't get it.
I would not be surprised if somehow Carter Ramos steps in and steals the series for Calgary.
Or Yoni Ordeo? Can we just
he
give
was
a
ra- awful.
Can he can't give- even catch a puck with his glove.
Because they
neither are- can the guy in Boston University who lost the national championship for his team, Matt O'Connor. Feels awful. That was the worst goal I've ever seen in the history of ever. I felt so bad for the kid.
I was watching it. I was watching it live, and I felt like Emperor Palpatine. I was like,
the evil run through with him. Here we can turn him now. Wins.
Yeah, that's your weekly college update.
Yeah, there you go. The one junior update a week you get for
there you
5 seconds.
Just
to say, Yoni Ordeo, they agreed at the start of the game it was a professional shinny game. They were both in. They weren't hitting each other. So Michael Hutchinson let in a goal. So then Yoni Ordeo's like, yo, move, Michael. And he's like, yeah. And just missed it.
No, Stafford didn't tell him he was going to raise the puck.
Yeah. No raises. No wraparounds and no raises.
There's no slap shots either, guys. Like,
there was no slap. Like, seriously. There was one. It was Michael Backlund, and he got hurt. And then they're like, oh, no. We said. We agreed.
I did see Dustin Byfuglien in the third period be like, fuck this shit, and take a couple runs.
He did. Okay, so are we going to go through picks? Because I'm pretty sure we're...
Yeah, let's... Who you guys got in the series?
Dan.
Canucks in 5.
Flames in seven.
I got, I say the longer this series goes, the worse it is for Vancouver.
Mm-hmm.
However, mm-hmm. Vancouver's going to find a way to win in six.
Oh, nice.
With Ryan Miller emerging as the star again.
I completely agree with you. The longer it goes, the worse it is for Vancouver. That's why I think they're just going to hammer down and...
I
just think Calgary's youth is going to catch up to them in the playoffs. That's
or it could be their reasoning for winning because, you know...
You never know.
They're playing against the Sedin brothers who were a little older. But this is really Vancouver's last shot. Like, after this, they might have to dismantle a bit of that core.
A little partial because the Jets-Vancouver games were nasty this year. So that would be a great second-round series.
And it's so easy to piss off Vancouver. It'd be like Boston-Vancouver all over again in the Stanley Cup Final if that were to happen.
The go-to, yeah.
Guys, we can dream. Let's move on to the next series. You picked Flames in seven?
Yeah.
You have Canucks in five? I have Canucks in six. Okay.
Yeah.
First time I'll ever pick Canucks, and last time I'll ever pick Canucks. Fucking hate the Canucks.
They gotta bounce back.
If there's a fucking fan base, I hate...
Sir?
I'm sorry. I respect...
We are nice to every fan base, okay?
I respect Vancouver fans' passion, but I think it's that Leaf... you know how a lot of people hate Leaf fans? I just don't like Canucks fans. I'm friends with Canucks fans, and I like them. But as a Canucks fan base as a whole
it's okay.
I don't like them.
You can dislike them.
Yeah.
It's fine.
It's like how most people...
Montreal. It's like Toronto. It's fine.
Okay.
Okay.
Next series. St. Louis, Minnesota. Season series went to the Wild. 2-1-1. The big question that surrounds the series is goaltending. On one side, you have Devin Dubnyk.
Dubnyk.
Don't you laugh. He's awesome.
Devin Dubnyk, who...
This is the reason
why Minnesota's in the playoffs versus question mark either Brian Elliott or Jake Allen.
Jake Allen, I think, has played. No, Elliott's played better against the Wild.
True, but they haven't really announced who the starter is. It looks like they're leaning towards Elliott, but probably on a short leash, which we've seen before in past playoff series, and it might not go well. You might just have to go with the guy. What do you guys think of this series?
Oh, this series is going to be. Okay, I'm not a big fan of St. Louis. I don't really like watching them play, but it's like. They've done so good this year. They finally have that extra oomph in Tarasenko. They finally have a go-to score guy. We've talked about it. You know what? I'm gonna go with what I've heard before. It's again with Vancouver. Now or never for the Blues. I know they have a lot. I know they have a bunch of other years to do it. But I feel like now is the best time because the Kings aren't in the playoffs. The Hawks. Apparently, Patrick Kane's coming back, but he's not 100%. So I mean, this is their time to not cakewalk to the conference final, but an easier path per se, only because Nashville is also they kind of let off the gas too. So it's now or never for St. Louis. That's my opinion. I already know who I'm picking. I'm wearing a shirt.
I already know who I'm picking. I think St. Louis gets over the hump and gets out of the first round this year.
See,
I Cam said, it's now or never. Dubnyk lost quite a few games down the stretch in the last 10 or so. Once then, I know they clinched already, but he still lost. So,
the thing is, too...
And St. Louis can beat Minnesota up. I'm not saying it's right, but they can physically outmatch Minnesota.
But go ahead, Greg.
Well, the way I look at it is, it seems that great goaltending seems to fluster St. Louis. In years past, obviously last year, they got stumped by an arguably even team in Chicago, a team that could score. But at the same time, Corey Crawford played an unbelievable series, and it was a great series from a physicality standpoint. I think Minnesota matches up St. Louis very well on the physical standpoint on the back end. I think Minnesota's very physical on the back end, not so much on the forecheck. I don't think they've got that depth. However, I think Minnesota matches up really well outside of just the goaltenders. I think Minnesota wins the goaltending. I like Minnesota's secondary scoring in this series a lot. Nino Niederreiter, Michael Granlund, Eric Halla. These guys are guys that emerged last year, and one of the things that I noticed last year with Minnesota when they were playing against Colorado is their zone pressure and their forecheck is unbelievable.
That's what sets them apart, I think, from these other teams, at least in the playoffs, in my mind at the moment. They're fast.
Fast.
Every line, two out of the three speed. Guys are above average speed, compared to, St. Louis isn't a very fast team, but they're a quick strike team. They always have guys in the right position. We know this being Jets fans.
I watched St. Louis. I went to two games, two Jets games. They're so good.
No, yeah, I know.
They're so tough to beat.
Yeah.
I think St. Louis is deeper than Minnesota.
Oh, I think we all agree that.
On forward and defense.
Oh, on defense, I'm not disputing that, but
I don't think Minnesota's defense is very deep outside of Suter. I don't.
Well, yeah, no, that's I think St. Louis
is tough.
Here's the other thing that I'm going to put towards Minnesota. Not only did they win the season series, they have their number one starter. They know what they're doing.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know why, but I have this dark horse hunch that Thomas Vanek's going to get hot.
That's fine. He played
well on the stretch.
One thing that...
fantasy hockey, thank you.
Yeah. One thing that you've said earlier in the year was, show me... What's a goalie quote again?
Show me a good goalie, I'll show you a good team.
Yeah.
Okay, show me a great goalie, I'll show you a great team. Right now, if you're confident in your goalie, like, that's one thing, back to Ducks. They might not be confident, but it's like, it's well, in your we head. Have to do it. Yeah. It's like, if your goalie's doing great, it's like, you can loosen up a bit. You don't have to hold that stick extra
tight.
That's
what the Jets are doing down the stretch.
Exactly, and they're doing it right now even. So it's like, yeah. I think that's only going to benefit Minnesota. It can't be against them.
Who you got?
Blues in 7. I think it's going to be close.
Minnesota in 6.
I do.
I will take Minnesota in 7. So okay. I have.
I'm on the island, I guess.
Well.
I just St. Louis, it's now or never.
No, that's good. We need opposites. We don't want to all just be like, go team. Because then it won't give us any reason to hate each other.
Minnesota winning would not surprise me, though.
No. And then our last matchup in the West, Chicago-Nashville.
This should be the most anticipated one, yet it's like...
Not talked about.
This is like the least anticipated for me.
No, that's what I'm saying.
I don't really care.
Oh, yeah. Season series a little lopsided with the Hawks winning 3-1 over Nashville. However, you have Pekka on one side, and you've got Jonathan Toews, Marian Hossa.
Corey Crawford.
Potentially Patrick Kane. Could play in game 1. So with all this, like Cam said, this should be a really highly anticipated series. But why isn't it to you, Dan? Why don't you feel that it gets anticipated?
I don't know. I mean, maybe because Nashville lost a lot of their steam in the last 2 months. Like, they were so good, and then they have a losing record since the All-Star break. I don't know. Maybe because Chicago wasn't as dominant this year as they normally are. You know, they weren't a powerhouse. You know, people still think they'll go far, but I don't know. I think it'll be entertaining. I really don't.
The one thing that I question this series is, and we've talked about it definitely in the Winnipeg series, we talked about it in the St. Louis series, is physicality. And I don't look at these two teams and see physicality as like the main focal point of the series. Yes, you have Weber on one side, and then you have the nastiness of Keith, who can just be a straight up dick, which we've seen in the past.
I love it.
When he told that woman reporter she shouldn't be reporting sports.
What about
the Jeff Carter move where he's?
I love that. That's arguably one of the best. I'm not for people getting hurt. I'm not cheering Jeff Carter, but I loved the action of Duncan Keith, and then he had the audacity and the balls to be like, what are you talking about? What, you can't, he took my stick. And they're like, yeah, into his face. I don't think he did that.
Good old Winnipeg, good boy.
It's a very, like, when you think about it, there's a lot of big names in this series. You got Shea Weber, Pekka Rinne, James Neal, Philip Forsberg. Then you go, Taves.
Whoa. And Mike Ribeiro.
Yeah,
don't you do that.
He had a good year.
Sorry, and
even
Mike Ribeiro. Roman Josi.
Yeah.
Dark horse guy who could emerge, Cody Franson.
True.
You never know.
And then the other thing, too, is then you have guys like, and Mike Fisher, like, who wouldn't be motivated being married to Carrie Underwood. Then you have, Taves, Kane, Hossa, Sharp, Richards.
Teravainen,
Saad, Shaw, like the list. Kruger.
Their top five guys are always there, and then they have a rotating cast of bottom six that just keep getting better.
I heard something about Vermette being in the press box for these games.
Oh yeah,
and they have him.
Yeah,
and Kimo Tebow.
Yeah.
Oh no.
See, Chicago's.
I didn't factor him into
Chicago's a deep, deep team, but I question the togetherness of this team.
Oh, because they're thrown together.
It's so many different parts kind of rotating around. Yes, I agree that guys like Shaw, Saad, Kruger, those guys are solid and they've been there for a while. But when you throw in guys like Vermette and Richards and Antimen, where you're just kind of recycling through, and then they have Johnny Oduya, who's just actually a pretty decent hockey player, but I'm going to chirp him anyways.
He's forever going to get capped for 3 minutes into the first game back, turn the puck over.
To
right
Mike Camilleri. Everyone will remember that.
The Oduya. Moment, whenever that I hear Oduya, I see Oduya, or Camilleri just Snapchat. Camilleri.
Oduya is actually a solid. He's a, he's a good defenseman. He's a solid defenseman.
However, it's quite interesting to know that this is not a very talked about series, but it could turn into quite a series because of just the underlines of maybe there's some turmoil in Chicago where they just can't get it done this year, where they're just not going to have the talent. And then you have the dark, like, the evident, like, brick wall that is Pecorine. Like, what do you do with that? Like, what if he can play so well that he can steal the series? We always talk about how goaltending can win you games.
He can steal you a Stanley Cup.
Exactly. And especially with the team they have now. They now have guys like Phil Forsberg and James Neal who can put the puck in the net. They still have Shea Weber, who's just an unbelievable defenseman.
Remember 3 years ago, Chicago ran to Arizona when Mike Smith was one of the hottest goalies in the league, and they couldn't. They lost.
Good.
Yeah, I don't totally remember that. I
think to Greg's point, though, if you look at the other series, Anaheim, Winnipeg, people expect that to be a bloodbath, which it probably will be. Vancouver, Calgary, probably not the most physical series, but they're going to hate each other because they're so close.
And like, they've played each other so many times.
Like, to each other,
yeah,
right?
They already do.
St. Louis, Minnesota, I think that's going to be a war. And then you look at this series, and I think this is going to be the tame, not much going on, low scoring, probably lots of overtime. That's just
what happens if, like, there's just this thing where Weber and Keith just develop this, like, hatred towards each other in the series.
Duncan Keith, he's not crazy. He's crazy. He's not that crazy. Have you seen Duncan Keith? His size. I'm talking his stature.
Yes.
Have you seen Shea Weber?
Yes.
That's why, who's that guy there who's, they signed him last time? Come on, not Bolin.
Bickle?
That's why Brian Bickle's there. Oh, okay. Brian Bickle's there to fight fights like that. Okay. And also be a great player.
So who you guys got?
Dan.
Hawks in six.
Nashville in six.
Nashville in seven.
Okay. I just want to say something popped in my head as you were talking about overtime. Out of the four Western series, which one will go to overtime? No, the longest overtime. Just one.
Winnipeg, Anaheim, game
three. I can't take it. Game three?
Yeah, I'm going to be there. I'm going to be there.
St. Louis, Minnesota. Two overtimes. Game four.
You know what? Because we're just talking about it, I'm saying three overtimes for Nashville, Chicago, and of course, Jonathan Toews or Patrick Kane is getting it, but I'll go Johnny T. He's got to.
Can you just imagine how crazy that MTS Center will be if that goes overtime and the Jets win?
No.
Can you imagine Porgent Maine?
I don't want that to imagine that. My dad's too old. He'll have a heart attack. Like, my dad will have a heart attack. He can't stay up that late. Anyways.
Right. Let's transfer to the East now.
Now, let's bring it down a notch, because East sucks.
Well, there are some pretty good series in the East.
Oh, beautiful series.
Montreal, Ottawa. Ottawa won the season series 3-1.
With the Hamburglar?
With the Hamburglar. Will Hammond the real questions in the series. Will Hammond continue his success? Can Price continue his dominance and potentially win a Conn Smythe? And, of course, will Stone continue to score big goals? Potentially this year's Calder Trophy winner.
I think this might be the most entertaining series of all of them in the first round.
This one will be high scoring. It won't be a super physical series. A guy like Chris Neal could change that just with physical play. I think it's going to be a lot of skill, a lot of speed, and it's going to be a goaltending showcase. However, I want to know if Hammond can keep up with the pressure.
Okay.
What do you guys think?
My thoughts on this series is Ottawa is clicking. Like, they're like, they're in like my the mind, Jets. They're reminded, in the way that they're rolling, it reminds me of the Jets. They're just clicking. It's going to be tough to knock them off. But Montreal also has the brick wall that is, that's my favorite line of this episode, obviously.
The brick wall.
The brick wall that is Carey Price. But what Montreal, they're one team that didn't change anything at trade deadline because they were confident in their team.
Well, they changed a few things. They changed bottom, like, three.
But they haven't really changed their team in the last 3 or 4 years.
Yes, but it somewhat worked. I mean, they went to the conference final. I was about to say Stanley Cup, but conference final last year.
And lots of people think if Carey Price had played, they'd be in the finals. So
yeah, there's that argument. It's a team that can score goals. It's a team that can piss you off with guys like Brendan Gallagher, Alex Galchenyuk, guys like that, as in continuing PK Subban. But I think as much of a headline is Hammond and Price. I think Subban versus Carlson, two of the best offensive defensemen in the game.
Yeah, I just drew blank on that for half a second there. That's going to be a good one.
Could be something else to watch. You could see all the young talent that Ottawa has. Guys like Hoffman and obviously Stone.
Combined with Bobby Ryan, they're getting Zibanejad McCulloch back.
Holy, that's a big get.
Yep,
I forgot about him.
Not Zibanejad. Zibanejad's a defenseman.
No, but whatever. Mahalik, that guy. Yeah.
Milan McCulloch.
Milan.
There
yes.
we go. Better and the better McCulloch
increases anyway. More scoring.
I just for the team. It's so hard to bet against Ottawa. It's so hard because of how they're 22-3-3 down the stretch.
It's something ridiculous like that. And like, Hammond's numbers are just out of this world.
And you want them to win. Like, they're the team that you... They're, as much as the Jets getting in the playoffs was a great story, this is like...
This is the feel-good.
Every time Canadian teams play each other, not just Montreal Canadiens, but Canadian teams, there's always going to be a losing city, which sucks, because then there's one less Canadian team. But it's always awesome. Like, I'm going to get... I'm looking at this on paper and I'm like, Montreal, Ottawa. Like, in my mind, I'm like, because it's not, you know, I don't pay attention.
It's not like Montreal,
Toronto. I'm probably going to get really invested in this just because.
It could become a bloodbath.
Eric Greiba.
His hit on Lars Eller.
I was sitting in a hospital waiting room watching that game and, like, one of the nurses, like, all the guys in the room were like, oh! And then the nurse came by and she's like, oh, that's stitches. She's like, oh, he's good.
Ottawa pissed Montreal off that year and they beat him quickly. I think it was 5 games.
Oh, really?
Or 6. Oh, it was quick. I mean,
Ottawa can be a dark horse. Remember, season series 3-1. And
it's so hard to bet against them.
I think a lot of it, as much as it has to lie on Hammond and Price, I think the underlying storyline is how well can both PK Subban and Erik Karlsson not play offense, but play defense. Because that's been an issue for both of them at times this season. Who you guys got? Series is picks.
Dang.
Go.
Went back and forth on this a lot, but I'm going to have to go Montreal in 7.
Oh,
heartbreaking overtime win, too, I think.
Ooh. I think one of the games is going
to
be overtime.
As much as I want to see it, as much as I want it to be a long one, Montreal in 5, they're shutting her down.
Yeah.
You think
so? Carey Price is going to do it.
Okay. Well, I'll be the lone wolf. Pick Ottawa in 7.
Oh, nice. Okay.
And Andrew Hammond getting potentially just... I'm not going to say murdered, but injured after the game by Montreal fans, because he'll just...
Oh, okay. I'm like, where are you going with this?
I'm not going like anywhere bad with it.
Max Pacioretty's going to do a Chris Kreider.
Yeah.
Slide out his leg.
I can't score on him!
All right.
Okay, next series. Still staying in the Atlantic Division. Tampa Bay, Detroit. Tampa Bay won the series 3-1. Now, here's the thing. This seems to be, as Dan mentioned, the Chicago-Nashville series seems to be kind of a lost series. I think that this one is also very much of a lost series. Not a lot of hype going into this series. A lot of people already favoring the Lightning over the Red Wings just because Red Wings are having issues with starting goaltenders. They announced, I think yesterday, that Peter Mrazek's going to start over Jimmy Howard.
Again, though, Eddie Lack's situation. Why not? Well, there's nothing to be...
Howard's played down the stretch, and he's not played well.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, no.
And he got called out by Babcock a couple times.
Detroit has kind of stumbled over the finishing line this year, and now we got to see
Tampa
Bay.
For the 24th year.
I mean...
God damn it. Clack.
But you have to keep in mind...
Clack.
Yes.
Up until the beginning of March, they were one of the best teams in the league.
Yeah.
And they did not win a lot of games in the last month, and they almost missed the playoffs.
And that is why I think this is, for a lot of people, a consensus pick of... Everyone's going Tampa Bay.
I don't think it's going to be that one-sided, though.
But
no, because it's Detroit and it's the playoffs.
Exactly.
You can't ever count them out.
I think there's equal scoring talent on both teams.
But I think here's the difference.
Tatar and Nyquist are 30 goals.
Oh, Abdelkader spread out. Okay, yeah. No, I'm thinking about him like Steven Stamkos.
Justin Abdelkader had 20-some-odd goals this year. I mean, I just...
No, yeah, okay, sorry.
I can agree with that.
I think they can match Tampa.
Here's where... I'm a little different, and I think, really, I really like Tampa Bay this year. They had the best line in hockey, plus minus. I know plus minus is a arbitrary stat. Best plus minus line of Nikita Kucherov, Tyler Johnson, Andre Platt. That is honestly, they're all high 20s, low 30s in the pluses. They all had 60 plus points this year.
They're all below the age of 24.
Yeah. That is not only an offensive line, but they can turn around and score. If that line is covering a Zetterberg line, or they're on the Tatar Nyquist line, it's going to be a tough task on the other side of the puck to control them offensively, because they're so good in the defensive zone that that defense turns into offense for them.
I think the one area... This is going
to be a line matching, like, good lord. This is going to be awesome.
I think the one area, Tampa Bay, I think their youth might hurt them. Because they honestly have a lot of guys in that team that don't have much playoff experience, if any. They're very young. They have very good young players, but they're still very young.
And they're going up against Detroit, they never miss the playoffs.
And Mike Babcock.
And their goaltending, I'm not totally sold. I mean, Bishop's good, but...
You're not sold on
him. You know, if he goes down, look what happened last year.
Vasilevsky, though.
He went down last year, and they got swept.
This is true.
With pretty much the same team they've got this year.
However, I think Lindback played his worst hockey of his career. I don't think...
You don't ever expect to get tossed in it like, yeah. Oh, I'm hurt. Like, last season?
He got thrown in there.
I don't know if Vasilevsky could... Obviously, I think their chances are way better with Bishop opposed to Vasilevsky. However, if I'm going to take a goalie in the series, I'm taking Bishop, because there's just so much controversy in Detroit. I wouldn't be surprised the longer this series goes if we don't see Jonas Gustafsson in this series. That's how crazy the goaltending situation is in Detroit this year.
And Detroit's defense arguably is very weak.
Yes. However, Marek Zidlicky has kind of helped the team out.
Yeah.
84 game player this year. Same with Keith Yandle. They both played 84 games.
Oh, cool.
Boom.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yep.
Hashtag stats. So what do you guys think?
Dan, who are you taking?
I'm going to go Detroit in six. They're my dark horse for the East.
Tampa in six.
I also pick... Fuck, I don't want to pick same as you. I'll pick Tampa.
No,
I'll go Tampa in seven.
Okay, nice. I'm going to go lower. So.
I've been proven wrong by betting against Detroit in the playoffs before. So.
Here's my thing with Detroit and where I think they're going to be a little bit better. If it's a line matching series, as Cam said... I have to pick Mike Babcock over John Cooper in that sense.
Of course.
Even though Cooper's a fantastic coach, I think he's done great things there, and I think Yzerman deserves the world. And I think this is a great matchup for Yzerman, considering that it's his freaking team that he was the captain of for ever.
Yep.
To knock them out of the playoffs would be a great feeling for him, because this is the team he built to model after what Detroit was. And I think that this is the Detroit system playing against an older Detroit system.
Oh, okay.
And I think that's
a more developed...
This is Detroit 10, 12 years ago against Detroit now.
Yes, exactly.
Oh, okay, yeah.
A legitimate...
Tampa being them.
Yeah, okay. Like Stamkos being the Yzerman.
Yeah.
And just the weird. Over... Like, yeah, if you think about it, like, that's what this team's designed to be. You gotta... I also agree with Dan, though, in the sense that I think Tampa Bay has a much stronger defensive core than what... Detroit has. And I bet they would really wish they had Eric Brewer right now.
You know what?
We will lend you
from Toronto. Who has Eric
Brewer?
Toronto. I think Tampa.
Oh, Tampa, you mean?
Yeah, Tampa.
They got Braden Coburn.
Especially with the...
Didn't he get hurt?
Yeah.
Is he out for the playoffs?
No, I think he'll be back. Especially with the goaltending troubles in Detroit, I think Tampa has all the advantages going into the series, but I don't know. I've been proven wrong betting against Detroit before. I mean, you know, 2 years ago they barely made the playoffs and played Anaheim, who was the best team in the league that year, I think, and they beat them.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Next series. Rangers, Pittsburgh. Rangers won the season series 3-0-1. For some reason, I have upset written all over this. My gut is telling me Pittsburgh is somehow...
Fleury's
going to trump all of his haters... And Crosby and Malkin are going to play like they did in 07, or in 08, 09. And I think the Rangers are going to falter.
Oh, Greg, I wish you wouldn't say that. Because I don't know. I have that same feeling. I'll let Dan get it up first.
I think the Rangers are just going to bend Pittsburgh over. Not to be blunt, but I just think they're going to have their way with them. Pittsburgh is so bad.
But are they? What happens? Like, the biggest thing with why...
All their decor are out. Yeah. Letang done for the year. Mata done for the year. But who else is out done?
There's wizardry in the playoffs.
I don't know, man. Just...
Mark Giordano, they did it. It can happen.
I mean, Crosby and Malkin, like, you know, their supporting cast is pretty good.
But they can get in the head of Henrik Lundqvist. They can do it. They could just...
There's two of them. It's funny. Not just one. As much as Cam didn't want to see Pittsburgh make the playoffs, I like the fact that you have the same feeling as me.
Because it's the Rangers. I hate the Rangers more than the Penguins. Okay.
Because they always beat the Flyers.
Yeah, hey! But, both of them. Hurts.
I think...
Not really Penguins. Sorry.
I don't know. I feel that if Crosby and Malkin can get it going, and then Perron obviously finds his way, and then you start getting guys like Patrick Hornquist into it, and Chris Kunitz starts picking it up, this team starts motoring again. Yes, they have defensive issues, but I think that they can overcome that by playing great offense, but Fleury has to be a stud in the net. Their advantage, obviously, is... Lundqvist hasn't seen a ton of game time between his injury in the playoffs. So I think that they can capitalize on
you
that.
You have to look at Rangers. Rangers, in my opinion, have the best, deepest top six defense in the entire league. They have Yandel, Boyle, McDonough, Girardi, Staal, and who else is on there? I don't know.
That extra guy.
That other one.
You know New York fans. You know.
But you know who he is.
You throw that with one of the best goalies in the world at a team that hasn't played well in the last month, I think it's too much for Pittsburgh.
Understandable.
To handle. I do. And Rick Nash apparently has refound his scoring touch, so.
That's scary.
That is scary.
Derek Stepan's playing well. Matt Zuccarello is going to be a little pest, which is fine.
Marty St. Louis always plays well in the playoffs. Yeah.
Marty St. Mama!
Doesn't he ever? Yeah. Poor Mama! Yeah, seriously, man.
Well,
Mama.
Hey.
That sucked last year. Sorry to hear that from
St. Louis. It was. And, you know, it was a heartfelt moment last year where Crosby went and saw him after it happened in the tunnel. Yeah, you didn't.
Oh, yeah.
And they got to relive that series again. But I don't know. Who do you guys have?
Greg, like, Dan, you go first. You're going to hate... Go
Rangers
ahead.
In five.
God, Daniel! No! That's who I had.
You had Rangers in five?
I had Rangers in five. You know what? No. You know what? Because I'll go Rangers in six.
Okay.
I would be...
Tune the Penguins horn over here and then not Rangers.
Well, no. I know.
I totally agree with you, though.
It's like, the momentum. What are you talking about? Like, oh.
The President's Trophy. I mean, that's a big thing.
No, but that's another thing. It's like, the Flyers fan in me is like, oh, no, Pens are done. Pens are done. But I'm like, well, they've done it before.
Because there were a lot of people last year who thought the Rangers did not deserve to be in the final. They weren't even comparable to the Kings. And they got smoked in the final because the East was very weak last year. And I think they're ready to prove people wrong this year.
I'm with you.
I think there's a resurgence. I think New York's hungrier this year. Obviously, part of me feels that there's just a weird upset potential here of voodoo. My gut is telling me to go Pittsburgh, but I'm going to go off my head and pick New York in seven to be different than you guys. However, for some reason, it's going to linger, and it might bother me if Pittsburgh wins a series, but I would say wouldn't be surprised if Pittsburgh wins a series. But picking New York in seven.
Okay.
The last series that we're going to cover today, Washington Capitals versus the New York Islanders.
I think this will be a great series.
Caps won the season series 2-0-2, and Cameron is fist pumping.
Oh, I can't wait for this one.
This will be a war, too. I think they're going to try and kill each other, too.
Yeah.
I just...
You know what? I was like, when the Capitals were like, they're like on the brink of missing playoffs, I was like, the world... Yeah, everyone hate... Like, a lot of people don't like Ovechkin. The world needs Ovechkin in the playoffs. He's awesome. I love him. He's awesome.
We need it.
Did we talk about this before the podcast? I'll say it again. Ovi had 53 goals this year.
Oh, yeah. No, you didn't say it on the podcast.
27 of his goals came from the left circle. Johnny Boychuk, anyone, whoever's
Nick
playing.
Nick Leddy,
the whole defensive core. If Ovi's on.
Calvin DeHaan.
You play D. You cover that left circle. Don't let him shoot it ever. Holy smokes.
Who is that decor? It's like Calvin DeHaan.
Calvin DeHaan.
Travis Hamonic.
Nick Leddy.
Thomas Hickey.
Johnny Boychuk. And Brian Strait? Or is he a forward?
STR.
And then they have Ryan Pulock, AHL, like one of the all rookie team, probably waiting in the wings if they didn't make playoffs. I'm not sure.
I think this is definite. Like, this is going to be. I think this series, this and the Montreal series, are the top two East series. Boy, oh boy. Like, Islanders, first time since the lockout shortened season. But I love the Islanders. I really do.
They have two thirds of your favorite line.
They're just.
Two thirds of your favorite
line. Oh, they're missing MacArthur. Yeah. Oh, my God. We talked about depth today. I think Islanders have that depth. And they got Johnny T. But, boy, like, you can't count. I love the Halak storyline, too, where it's his old team in Washington.
Because
they got Halak last year for the playoffs, didn't they? Or was that two? Last year, yeah, they got Halak last year for the playoffs, right?
No, two years ago?
Wasn't it? I thought it was last year. No. When did Washington get Halak? Ooh. Was it last
Maybe
year's
trade? 3 years ago.
2 years ago.
It was 2 years ago?
Oh, sure.
Lockout year.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
I think that might be a little bit more of a reason for him to want to win. Might just play a little bit better. However, it's Braden Holtby, and he's played really well this year.
And I just want to say for the broadcasters for this series, can you please bring back the Braden Holtby mom vision when it showed his mom? Because she's the most entertaining parent of them all.
Yes.
Malkin's parents.
The old Manitoba boy, too.
Yeah.
What? How about this?
Whoa.
How about
Braden Holtby's from Manitoba?
No, he's not.
Brandon, isn't he? Or is he from Saskatchewan?
Saskatchewan.
Sorry, whatever.
Here's the thing.
Okay.
If we want him on TV, I'm sure Sportsnet will cut a deal where they'll just put Sportsnet shirts on their parents, and then they'll be able to show them whatever they want.
Well, they're the most entertaining parents because the most boring parents are Malkin's parents. They just sit there. They're like, pam, pam, pam.
Sakak's dad's probably one of the most intense parents. When you're Sakak scored his first NHL goal at the beginning of the year, and he's just like cheered like Mark Chipman did after Bogosian scored that overtime shootout goal against the Leafs.
I'm excited for this series. I think Winnipeg Anaheim is going to be the most entertaining. Not, and that may be just from personal.
We're totally biased. That's fine.
But I think that's going to be entertaining hockey because the games they played were mean and they were high scoring and they were close. I think this could be the second.
Dan, I'm with you. That's my series in the East that I'm like, I'm going to watch. Yeah. I'm watching that one.
I'm also going to watch Montreal.
Of course we're all going to watch all of them.
This one, I think, could be.
Yeah.
This could be really good.
So you guys got?
Dan.
I'm going Islanders in 7 because I want to see New York in round 2.
Oh, nice.
And I think the Islanders are going to go a little ways this year.
Okay. Fine. Washington in 6.
Damn it. I'll change my pick.
Greg,
come
it's an
Island again. Come on.
Washington in 7.
Okay.
Now, I have a stipulation here. I'd love to see the Islanders win this series.
Oh, of course. Of course.
You don't want to see Rangers-Islanders in the playoffs.
I think Rangers and Islanders in the playoffs would be a fantastic series. But who doesn't want to see Washington Rangers again?
For the 28th time.
Where Washington finally slays the King and wins the series.
I just want to say before we wrap up this series, okay, they were saying Nassau Coliseum, are they playing there for playoffs?
Yep. Yeah.
Oh, it was just the last regular season. Because I'm like, where are they going to play for playoffs? They're like, damn it, they made the playoffs. No, keep the ice in.
Shit.
Cancel the circus. It's over.
Put the video screen back up. Yeah. Put it in the center.
The 18-year-old Greg inside of me wants to see. I don't want it to happen. Like, hockey gods. Like, so much of me wanted Washington-Pittsburgh first round. But Washington-Pittsburgh second round would just be the world.
That's what you have?
No, but I would love to see that.
Oh, yeah.
You don't want to see New York, New York. They would try and kill each other.
Here's
It'd be
the thing.
Great.
The only,
yeah, I'm with
the
you, Dan, only, but it's called Crosby Ovi again.
We've seen it.
I know, but they'll reignite it again.
Here's the only thing. The only matchup I don't want to see out of the Metropolitan is Islanders-Penguins. There's nothing there for me. I think New York, New York is great. I think Washington, New York is great. Washington-Pittsburgh trumps them. That would be great, too.
I don't know.
But yes, Subway Series would be cool because it happened in MLB and it'd be cool to see now. Especially
have they ever played in the Islanders?
Yes. Back in the 70s, I'm sure they did. Or 80s, I'm sure they did.
That's Jaya, right?
Okay,
guys. Are
we
going to do our quick
Nobody picked a sweep. Nobody picked a sweep?
No, because this year it is...
The teams are
too good. Dude, all my East matchups are Game 7s. I don't have anything less
there
than
a game
six.
There could be a lot
six.
Of game seven.
I have one game seven.
Guys, we can. This is actually one of the most wide open years. Everyone said it. No one really knows who's going
to
win.
You know it's wide open when some experts are picking the Jets to win the cup.
Yes. Like, but here's, like, I mean, here, legitimately, it's going to be Anaheim. If Winnipeg gets past Anaheim, they play Vancouver or Calgary. Most likely can beat them
this
out
of... This is your final four?
No. I'm just talking... Winnipeg plays Vancouver, Calgary. They beat them physically. I think if Pavlik can steal a few games, Winnipeg wins that series. Then they go on and most likely will play St. Louis, even though I have Minnesota win that series. Most likely St. Louis or Chicago. Another series where I think they can win and they'll physically beat the living shit out of whoever they play. So, I think the East is going to win just because whoever comes out of the West is going to be physically just... destroyed by the
or
end of it.
Or maybe they'll be so numb that they'll be hitting so hard that they'll just throw even more hits.
I think
that could be it too.
I think I'm going to agree with you because I'm not going to say what my Western final is, but it's going to be a war. Well, and I think whoever gets
no,
it,
go
yeah, we're
right
going we're gonna pick our final four.
Our final four.
Final
Dan,
four?
Go
East or what? Okay, on the
West
east,
and then East.
East. Okay, I'm going East first.
Okay, East.
East. I'm going to go Islanders, Canadians.
Oh, nice. Very and nice. Who's coming out of them?
Islanders.
Okay.
To the final.
Yep.
Nice. West side.
West, I'm going Jets, Blues.
And who comes out of that?
St. Louis.
Okay.
I wouldn't be upset if Jets came out. I'm just saying.
All right.
I wouldn't either, but
yeah,
I,
yeah, of course.
For them to go all the way in year one, I don't know.
That's,
you don't want to say it just yet.
Here's the thing. Like,
they aren't going to lose to St. Louis by much if they lose, though. That's my opinion.
I think every series, if whatever the Jets, I think they're scoring like 6 or 7. I think a lot of these series is this year are going to go 6 or 7. I'll go next if you don't mind. Ken.
Yeah, go.
I'll go Tampa Bay and Washington.
Yes, Greg, right here.
Yeah,
same.
Friendship.
Yeah.
And
you
then,
gave it away.
That's okay.
And then I'll go Nashville.
Ooh. Oh, I thought you had Nashville coming out of the winner of that. I was like,
no,
wow, that's some weird.
No, the winner of that.
Nashville, St. Louis, Cup final.
The winner I have out of that is going to be Washington.
Ooh, that's where we defer. Right. I have Tampa.
And then, so then I have Nashville. I can't not pick Winnipeg. I can't not pick Winnipeg.
Okay,
then.
Okay.
Like, as much as I want to say, okay, I think Anaheim, like...
Yeah, yeah.
It's whoever wins that series between Winnipeg and Anaheim is going to be in the conference final.
Okay.
I know you're picking Anaheim.
No.
Are you going Winnipeg, Washington, Southeast Division, Stanley
I'm going Winnipeg,
Washington. And who you got winning? Who do you have winning? Who do you have winning, Greg?
Come on, Greg.
Here. No, no.
On
here.
The clock.
No, actually, I'm not. No, I don't have Winnipeg. I want to do as much as I want to frickin' do it.
Hey, an expert picked it, so it wouldn't be far-fetched.
Fine. Go on, Winnipeg, Washington. Washington 6, because it's not 2019.
Okay.
We're going to win the cup here. That's bold.
Okay, so, as I said earlier, Tampa and Washington, and I have Tampa going from the east. And this is wrong. You guys are all wrong. Cameron has
Minnesota.
Minnesota, Calgary, Western final. Calgary remaining victorious out of the West. And then Tampa in 6. Steven Stamkos of the Conn Smythe, 24 goals.
So you think it's 0-4 all over again?
0-4 all over again. I got hit in the head real hard earlier this week. Yeah! There will be no stepping stones to
okay.
the way.
So, Stanley Cup Finals. Are Dan has go again, just review.
I have St. Louis Islanders and I'm taking Blues in 7. It's the like I said earlier, it's their year, they have to do it.
Washington, Winnipeg
in
Washington 6.
Okay,
yeah, I feel good about that. Go
Calgary, Tampa in 6. My East. Is totally realistic. And in all reality...
Your West is with your heart.
West is in my heart, in my head, actually in my head. I honestly could see the Ducks in the final.
And same
but
here.
I'm taking Calgary because screw it, wizardry. What is
voodoo,
it? Voodoo,
hate.
Voodoo, wizardry, and bullshit.
Yeah.
That's why.
Yeah, and I think that... That's the thing. I think whoever comes out of that series is our Western Conference champs. Something is about that series that just gets me excited. And yeah, maybe the Jets won't do it, and that's totally fine with me. They're in it. And I think that alone is just so exciting. And it's really makes me feel like a kid, makes me feel so happy to see a team in the playoffs that I cheer for.
One reason I could see the Jets going all the way is that building is going to be tough for anyone to go in and play in.
That is going to be a loud mother effing building. Like, that is just, that might be the loudest. Like, for 15,000, like, that'll rival some Seattle Seahawks games. That'll rival a lot of things.
It's
going to
be ridiculous.
It's a small town, small arena. Well, we're like, on top of you.
And you know, yeah.
The thing is,
even if they go out in the first round, just that first game is going to be.
How loud is the Anderson chant going to be? Or the Gibson chant? God. So loud.
Thank you for having names that we can, like, what are those?
Anderson.
No, but what are those called when you're like Cameron?
Three syllables?
Syllables. Thank you for having syllable names.
Multi-syllable names.
Yes.
Multi-syllable.
God. Not what like a rough black. Week, guys.
Yes. How, like, it, wide open. However, we talked about 16 teams. Let's reflect on the 14 who didn't make it. For the final, McEichel, Finn Stromer watch of the year.
14, no, no, we're
no.
just...
No, no. We're going to focus on the bottom five. But we've done this all season. We decided to do a final wrap of the worst five teams. And really...
Before we find out the official rank.
But these are the bottom five. Four of these teams have been there all season. With one of them emerging in around February into this McEichel Finn watch.
Who's that, Greg?
That'd be Toronto.
Okay, and then who's fourth?
Well, no. Fifth is Carolina. Fourth is Toronto. Third is Edmonton. Second is Arizona. First is Buffalo.
So
which
Buffalo
means
guaranteeing.
Buffalo guarantees Eichel or McDavid. Arizona could pick as low as third. Edmonton can pick as low as fourth. Toronto could pick as low as fifth.
Did you guys know that next year the draft lottery is for the top three
yes.
picks?
Well, no, the way they'll do
they're
it, okay.
Pick, they're going to pick for all, they're going to pick yeah. for the first pick, pick for the second, and pick for the third.
I will also put this
and
out there.
Whoever's left.
I'll also put this out there. For all Jets fans listening, every Winnipeg Anaheim game will be on Sportsnet, which is to the dismay of a lot of fans, but at the same time, hey, at least it's on TV. It's too
playoff
bad it's not Bayock.
They made the playoffs.
If you don't want to listen to it, then just put Bayock and 90 on 1290 and watch the game.
They might be ahead or
the radio's usually
by
ahead though.
Yeah. That's fine. It's an excellent option.
Yep. It's another option for you guys. So yes, Dan's right about that. I just want to put that out there. This year they're not filming the draft lottery. Very interesting because it's probably the most historic draft lottery ever. Like,
in
maybe
recent years?
At least in recent years. There's been some really good
first. Since the Crosby lockout tired NHL draft.
As I told Cam on the way here, you can look at the top five picks. Let's say the top five picks are McDavid, Eichel, Hanifin, Strome, and Mitch Marner. Comparables. Sidney Crosby. Mike Modano. I'm just going to pick a defenseman who was really good in the past, and Paul Coffey. I don't know if that's Hanifin's actual relative player.
A good player.
A good hockey player. Strome. You know, a big center. 6'3". Ryan Getzlaff. Mitch
that's
Marner.
That's actually Eichel's comparable.
Is it? Yeah. Okay. Nonetheless. But I'm...
Still, big boy.
Big boy. Sorry. And then Stromner, another unbelievable player. The fact that the NHL is not broadcasting this, I feel they're missing out on something. Or maybe it was just simply the major television network in Canada decided that, oh, we don't want to film that. It's not going to make much money. Maybe that's
why. Sportsnet pooping on the parade.
Well, I don't know. Like, I heard once
they were going to film it. They were going to film it and then release it on, like, their website. You'll see the numbers. I'll watch it.
Everyone will... Yeah, you'll be able to see it. It'll be in a preview show on Sportsnet. They'll talk about it on NBCSN, where most of the playoff games will be in the U.S. It's going to be interesting, because that's the most exciting time for those bottom five teams and even all 14 teams. I think it's scary, the fact that both Boston and L.A. have a chance to get McDavid.
It's not very... I mean...
It's not likely.
I think... I think those two teams are going to look a lot different next
guys,
year.
Guys, I just want to go on record and say, if Boston or LA get pick one, Winnipeg is playing Pittsburgh in the Stanley Cup final, because that's about as likely as that happening.
That's true.
Those are not hard numbers. Those are numbers pulled out of my ass right now.
So if LA wins the draft lottery next week, then we know that it's going to be Pittsburgh-Winnipeg.
You can just pretty much hammer it in. You're going to want to remortgage your house and put a lien on it.
A lien on it?
A lien. I heard that.
What is a lien, Cameron?
A lien on your house. It's like you bet money.
You're going to lien on your house?
No, that's like a lien on your house. You never heard those? It's like a type of more. You know what I'm talking
I'm
about.
I'm in finances, and I've never heard of lien on a lien house. On,
yeah, like a lien. Like, it's like a bet. It's like, okay, so.
Oh, I've never heard of this.
Okay,
oh,
well, it's like.
I thought you were trying to out-businessman him.
No, I've never actually heard of this.
Yeah, it's like I'm in the betting intrigued. World, it's like, okay, you.
Oh.
Dan, you own this house, okay? You say.
So it's like a poker game. It's like, I'll put up the keys to my house if you put up the keys to your Lamborghini kind of thing.
I guess so. If someone knows the exact.
So you put your house. What you're saying is, if L.A. Or you Boston wins it, you're putting your house up as kind of the bet.
The towards insurance of that. No, it's more the insurance of, so you're putting I owe you this money.
$400,000 bet yes. on a Pittsburgh-Winnipeg
fight. And my house is the insurance that I will pay it. Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
You learned a little bit here today?
Knowledge.
Yeah. Any closing words?
Guys, we didn't argue this week.
No, it was good.
Because we're all concentrated on our picks.
Yes.
Mm. And school's over, so everyone's happy.
It's not over yet for me. It's fucking
insane. It's
not
over. It's never over.
Like, I don't think I've had. I have 9 assignments due between now and next Thursday. 6 presentations.
Yikes.
4 papers.
And way too many NHL to watch to worry about those things. Am I right? Dan, closing words.
I just think Jets making the playoffs means everyone's happy.
As he fades away.
Wear white on Monday.
A storm is coming!
Check us out on Twitter at LastManNPC. Check us out on email us at gmail.com, LastManNPC at gmail.com. Check our YouTube out at LastManNPC. Until next Tuesday, guys, and after 3 Jets playoff games. Talk to you guys later.